Once again, I welcome to 6th grade students. Right. So, in the previous class, we have learned how to draw a bar graph. So, in the exercise 9.4, we have still some problems are there. Today, we will finish that problems.
Right.
So, keep reading in your notebook, exercise 9.4. Right. Take your textbooks. See. Which problem? Third one. Okay. So third one. So you have to listen carefully. I am reading. You have to read in your mind. Okay. Following table shows the number of bicycles manufactured in a factory during the years 1998 to 2002. Illustrate this data using a bar graph. Choose a scale of your choice. Listen carefully. Following the table shows. Given table given. Given one table. Okay. The downside given. That information shows the number of bicycles. Okay. Bicycle means how many wheelers? Two wheelers. Right. Bicycle manufactured in a factory during the years 1998 to 2002. Number some bicycles are manufactured. Okay, so this data, using this data, what you have to do? You have to draw a bar graph. Choose a scale of your choice. So we will take here the scale, the unit length is our choice. Okay, na? Giving according to the information, we can take that one. First, see the table. Years 1998. How many bicycles manufactured here? 800. 1999, 600. In the year 2000, 900. 2001, 1100. 2002, 1200. Okay. First, using this information, we have to draw a bar graph. So, before going to draw, see how much unit length we will take here. Here, the information in the hundreds form. Okay. One unit length. Now, I am taking here 100. Okay, no? Right. So here the scale is one unit length is equal to 100 bicycles. So 100 bicycles, right? Okay, take your pencil and the ruler. Ruler is nothing but scale. Okay, draw one horizontal line. Okay, next, draw one vertical line, that is y-axis and it is x-axis. Okay, right. So on the x-axis, which information we have to take? Number of years. So here years I am taking. Years. So that is years start from 1998 to 1999, 2000, 2001, 2002. Okay, right. On the y-axis, which information we have to refer here? So here number of bicycles manufactured, right, in the year 1998. So number of bicycles manufactured 800, na? So here I am taking the one unit length is 100. So next, 200, 300, 400, okay, 500, next 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000, 1100, extending the line 1200. Okay, now right. Next, now I am drawing a bar graph. 1998, number of bicycles manufactured 800. So here 800 is there. Now I am drawing here. Sorry, this one. This is the number of bicycles manufactured in the year 1998, 800. After 1999, 600. Here 600. So straightly, okay, straightly you have to draw 600. After that, 2900. 900 here we come. So 900. Bicycles manufacturer 900. Next 2001 1100. So 11 means above, 900 above. So 1100 strictly you have to draw. So it is the information about number of bicycles manufactured in the years. Right. Next last year 2002. How many? 1100 is more than 1100. So in the previous year 1100, 2002 year manufactured 1200 bicycles manufactured. Very good. Right. Next, come. This is the information about number of years manufactured. That is, in the year different years manufactured. Okay, so types of bicycles manufactured, number of bicycles manufactured in the different year. Next, come to the question A. In which year were the maximum number of bicycles manufactured? In which year maximum number, maximum means more. Okay, so here more bicycles manufactured in which year? Here which number is more? 600, 800, 900, 1100, 1200. 1200 is more. That's why in the year 2002, 1200 bicycles were manufactured. So which year manufactured more number of bicycles? 2002. Write that answer. Okay. So in the year 2002, in the year 2002, the maximum given information there, as it is, you write, maximum number of bicycles were manufactured. So that is 1200 bicycles, 1200 bicycles. And the second one, in which year were the minimum number of bicycles manufactured? Minimum means less, okay? More here 1200, less number of bicycles manufactured in which year? Less means 1200 less of 1100. Again 1100 below 900. 900 below 800. And reached 800 below 600. That means it is the least number of bicycles now. Yes, 600 bicycles were manufactured in which year? 1999. Very good. So write that answer. In the year 1999, okay, the minimum number of bicycles were manufactured, that is 600 bicycles. 600 bicycles. Very good. Students, I hope it is very easy to you. Okay. Drawing a bar graph is very easy. Okay. Compulsory you have to remember. scale is compulsory. How to? So how much scale one unit and you are taking, that one is very very important. Remember carefully, scale is important. And so this x-axis, y-axis, which information you are taking, that one also you have to mention neatly. That one also very important. After that, presentation is also very important. Okay, so use pencil, use pencil. Don't use pen, use pencil. Then only you will see the visual representation is good. Okay, very nice. Next, last problem, see children, fourth one. Number of persons in various age groups in a town is given in the following table. Age group 1 to 14, 15 to 29, 30 to 44, 45 to 59, 60 to 74, 75 and above. So in the number of persons given, 1 to 14 age 2 lakhs peoples are there. 15 to 29 age group 1,60,000 are there. 30 to 44 age, in between 30 to 44, 1,20,000 persons are there. 45 to 15, so that means in between 45 and 59, 1,20,000 are there. 60 to 74, 80,000 and 75 age, above 75 age, 40,000 persons are there. Okay, so draw a bar graph to represent the above information and answer the following questions. Here, take the 1 unit length is equal to 20,000. Here already has given the unit length. The scale we have to take, 1 unit length is 20,000. Okay. So here the information about the persons of different age groups, different types of age groups are given. So 1 to 14 number of persons, how many number of persons are there. Okay. So that information given, we have to use this information. Next, after that, you have to draw a bar graph. Are you ready? Right. Now take your bar graph and draw the graph. Right. So first here unit length given. So what is the unit length here? Scale. Scale is compulsory, I told you. Here 1 unit length is equal to 20,000. Right. So on the x-axis, which information we have to take? See, age group or number of persons. Okay, so we will take here the ages. Okay, so the ages. On the y-axis, we will take number of persons. Number of persons. So this is y axis and this one is x axis. Age group. First here age group is 1 to 14 age. Next 15 to 29 age. Next group 30 to 44. And next age is 45 to 59. Next 60 to 74. After that 75 and above. Okay. Now I have taken here the ages of the different persons. On the x axis, on the y axis, I am taking the number of persons. So number of persons are here 2 lakhs. So there is 2 lakhs information. Okay. So 2 lakhs and next 2. 1,60,000. So see children, not 2 lakhs. What you have to take? 20,000. Each unit length is equal to 20,000. Next 40,000. After 60,000. Next 80,000. After that 1 lakh. Next 1,20,000, 1,40,000, 1,60,000, next 180,000. So 2 lakhs is there? Yes, 2 lakhs na. So 2 lakhs after that 2 lakhs. Okay, to 20,000 after 20 and 20 40 40 after 60 60 80 1 lakh 1 lakh 20 1 lakh 40 1 lakh 60 1 lakh 80 2 lakhs. Okay, right. So after that 1 to 14 age group, how many people's number of persons are there? 1 to 14. So see the table, 2 lakhs people's are there. 2 lakh means top one. Here this one, 2 lakh people's are there. So in the 1 to 15, 2 lakh people's. How many zeros to after? 5 zeros. 2 lakhs. Next, 15 to 29, 1 lakh 60. Where is the 1 lakh 60? 1 lakh 80 below. That is here. 1 lakh 60,000 peoples. This is 1 lakh 60,000 persons are there. 30 to 44 age, number of students 1 lakh 20. So here 1 lakh above. So 1 lakh 20. Here 1 lakh 20. This is 1 lakh 20,000. 45 to 59, 1 lakh 20. Here the same group na. 1 lakh 20. So this is 1 lakh 20,000. So right above the bar, so it will shows the information quickly. Right, 60 to 74, 80,000. 80,000 here, 80,000. This 80,000. 75 and above age, how many members? 40,000. Less. 40,000 persons only are there, 75 and above age, and 80, 90 age groups, okay, more than 75. Right, now, so we have drawn a bar graph using the information, okay. Next, come to the questions. Which two age groups have same population? Same population, observe here, 1 to 14 and 2 lakhs. 15 to 29, 160,000. That means 1,60,000. 30 to 44, 1,20,000. 45 to 59, 1,20,000. 60 to 74, 80,000. 75 above 40,000. Apply carefully, which age group has same number of person? Very good. So this 30 to 44 having 1,20,000. 45 to 59, 1,20,000. Here we have to write which age groups? This age group, 30 to 44, 45 to 59. So write your answer. The two age groups which have same population. Which have the same population are, so groups ma, age groups 30 to 44 and 45 to 59. Same age, same population having this, between these age groups. Next, all persons in the age group of 60, okay, so understand this question. All persons in the age group of 60 and above are called senior citizens. Above 60 age, who are having above 60 age, that persons are called senior citizens. Okay, how many senior citizens are there in the town? How many senior citizens? So 60, more than 60 age, how many persons are there? 60 age means here. Okay, 62, 74, 75, above age group, all people are senior citizens. Okay, so like that, more than 60 age group, number of persons, how many number of persons are there? In the 60 to 74, how many persons? 80,000. 75 above, 75 age above. So how many persons are here? 40,000. Total 80,000 plus 44,000, 1,20,000. Now tell me number of senior citizens in the town. 1,20,000. Very good. So write that answer. Senior citizens are the senior citizens are the persons between the age group either from 60 to 74 or from 75 above. Okay, above citizens in the town is equal to 80,000 plus 40,000 is equal to 1,20,000. Okay, so hence the number of senior citizens in the town are 1,20,000. So how many senior citizens are there? 1,20,000. Right. Okay, students, up to now we have completed exercise 9.4. Okay, so today we have drawn different bar graphs of different information. Using the different information, we have drawn the bar graphs. Right. Okay, so this ninth chapter is completed today. So in the ninth chapter, what did you learn? What is the data? Okay, so how to show that data in the form of pictures, pictograph and bar graph, how to draw a bar graph. So using the tally marks, how to show the information, how to prepare a frequency table. So these all things you have learned in the data handling chapter. So remember, so it is very easy and simple also. You but getting the marks scoring chapter this one. So don't forget to practice once again. Remember, once again you have to practice this chapter and remember the definitions also. Right. Okay, so still if you have any doubts about the bar graph, okay, so you have to participate in the live interaction. You can clarify your doubts. Today evening you will get the homework. So that homework you will send in the Google form. Okay, children, bye. Have a nice day.